Hi, good day everyone. With the MCO, home learning has become a norm. So today's video is to teach you how to make a learning journal, or they also call it learning binder, learning file, however you want to name it. But I want to teach you a simple one that has been effective with my own 4-year-old daughter. Right now, this is the first page. All the materials I have basically just typed in either Microsoft Word or printed it out of my printer. Right, so we're gonna start with the basic. She is currently 3.5, moving on to 4 years old. I would think that you can start off this folder as young as maybe 3, closer to the age of 3. Now, on the first page, my own child is quite okay with capital letter because all of the posters that are around are of capital. So I've done the first page with lowercase letters. And what we do is, first she will say A, B, C, she'll sing the A to Z song. And then after that, we will do the phonics on street. We'll go ah. B, K, D, E, F, and so on. If you want me to tell you all the phonics sound, just leave a comment in the box below and I might do one later on. But again, I am no expert. I am a school teacher, but I am not specifically trained for preschool. But yeah, this somehow worked for my daughter. It's also from other YouTube videos. I'm just doing my own edition or my own version of it. Alright, so once we've done with this, so we quickly just go through the sounds, the letters. This shouldn't take you more than 1 minute. Do not make your child stick on this. Do this repetitively every morning. With mine, I do at evening or at night. That's when she learns the best. But yeah, it depends on what time works well for your own particular child. Second page. I do not put anything here because I wanted to just focus on this side. But you can later add on this side. We've got the numbers. Then she tells me the number. What I make her do is, I ask her to take her finger and trace the number. So she goes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, just a quick correction. I was not happy with this 9. This is the 9 that appears everywhere, but this is not the number that they usually write. So if I would suggest or advise you to change the 9 to the 9 that we usually learn, with the straight line over here instead of curving, she gets it confused. When she's doing this 9, she tells me it's 6. Yeah, so then 10. Then I've added 11 to 20. Then she goes 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then she goes on. Now this side, I used on over here. Then she goes on to say 17, 18. Again, make your child trace so that they will know the shape of the numbers. Also, you go 19, 20, this way. Or even Malay, 20, 21, 22, 17. So they can alternate between both Malay and English. And then for shapes, square, circle, triangle, oval, rectangle, heart. You may have seen in other videos where they used Velcro stickers and they've got the shapes at the side laminated to stick. I'm going to be honest with you, I'm a lazy mom. That's why I've put there for lazy moms and on the title of the video. This is easy. It took me less than 5 minutes, but I do it every day with her and it has worked. She can easily recognize the shape oval. She still gets square and rectangle a little bit confused, but she's got the other shapes down. Now, this one I've recently added. It's worked well with her. The days of the week, Sunday to Saturday. You can have a Malay version as next to it as well, like Ahad, Isnin, Selasa, kat tepi ni. So for the days of the week, she says the song. So she goes Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Woohoo! So then I do this every day, and you know, surprisingly, within a week, she's able to recognize about Sunday to Tuesday and Friday, Saturday. So she's still working on Wednesday and Thursday, probably because it's a little bit more harder to pronounce, perhaps. Yeah. Now this one, I've added for fun because my husband and I come from different countries and I wanted to know the continents first, but it's actually worked better than what I thought. She can actually identify North America, South America. And then when I showed Antarctica, I'm like, oh, where do all the penguins live? And then she's like, oh, Antarctica. And then we go on to say, oh, where's Malaysia? And then she goes, Malaysia. Her father's from Sri Lanka. So then I ask her, where's Sri Lanka? And she's able to point out Sri Lanka. Then I teach her Asia, Europe, Africa, Australia. Yeah? So this is the basic world map. Moving on, this is her name. Obviously, you change it to your own child's name, put in their own photo. And she loved this page a lot. So she goes to say, my name is Jayalakshmi. And then she says, nama saya Jayalakshi, right? So this is another, I think this is actually quite good. You can go on to add age, hobby, father's name, mother's name. A good one will also be a handphone number, like father's handphone number, mom's handphone number for emergencies. Now this one is Suku Kata Bahasa Malaysia. So here, I've added all of the Malay suku kata. We've got 1, 2, 3. So I've done up to Z. Yeah, sampai Z. So here what we do is, we go demi consonant lah. So we go B-A-B-A, B-I-B, B-U-B-U, B-I-B-A, B-O-B-O. Then we go C-H-R, C-I-T, C-U-C-U. She's still learning Malay, so this is something relatively new to her. So I thought it's just good to add it on. So she does, she's still at C. So I only do one consonant a day. Don't get your child confused. Don't make it too stressful for them. Yeah, so we haven't gone to this page yet. Alright, then now here I've added a reading book with her. You can add any book you want. So she's doing working on the A sound. Again, you can print these words out. You can just put it into the journal as well. Ends on the apple. And then she does this repetitively as well to learn the vowel A. And then once I've done that, I do... This is her preschool book. So then I do Malay reading with her. And then she goes through simple words like this. Oh, ibu, bubu, bibi. Dia dah tahu dah kan all the B consonant. So I just go that with her. And that's... That's it. That's all my learning journal for now. And it only takes like maybe, 10 minutes at the most. That too is only because the reading might take longer. But it just, the journal is just very short. Later, I might be adding newer things to my own learning journal or learning file or learning binder. However you want to call it. But this is like the fastest, easiest way to do this. Trust me, I just went, googled up the resources. It took me like what, maybe 15-20 minutes to get this done. Doesn't take you long. I've used a pretty old file like this because I can just take out whenever I want. You can use a dry marker like this. Make sure you use the whiteboard one. So if you want them to hold it and write 1, 2, 3. So again, this works, and what's the beauty is it wipes off clean. So instead of spending money on the items from Shopee, sorry, I used my hands. I'm not so hygienic. We should have used either wet wipes, or you can just use normal wet tissue to get this done. So you can use, again, marker to also to go through, fingers to trace, up to you really. These are all just easy methods. I hope you found my video on this particular learning journal helpful and useful to you. Again, letters, numbers. Here, pause whenever you want so you can know what, and then shapes. If your child has not conquered colors, please do add in color. Mine is quite good with color, so I have not added color into her folder. Days of the week. Suggestively, another one, once they've mastered this, is to move on to the months of the year. So we do all the way from January to December. And then once you're done with this, you can go into the oceans. Once she knows the oceans, you can go into like countries. Maybe because we stay in Malaysia, you can just focus around Malaysia or Singapore, Hong Kong, Japan, India, China, Malaysia, Indonesia, just around there, and maybe Australia. This one is pretty good. You can try other things, like I've said, add mom, dad's name, and then the letters of the consonant, and then maybe more reading words, because kids at the age of 4 should start picking up reading, so we can add that. You can add some more maths as well, like time and all. Yeah, please do drop comments in the box below if you want me to cover more into what you can add into this folder. Hope you found this help very helpful. Thank you.
Mama, I'm pretty making
him. Okay, continue teaching him.
Mama, I'm...
Okay, teach.
No,
it's only got 3 points.